Heroin is strangling Baltimore.
It's called carfentanil. People are dying and overdosing from the toxic opioid.
Everyone has to be in the game about combating opioid addiction.
When people think of Baltimore, drugs and crime are never far from their mind. The media calls it the heroin capital of the U.S., that it's ground zero for America's opioid crisis. But some residents are hard at work finding ways to lessen heroin's grip on their city.
The hope is we can warn them and let them use whatever powers they can to save their own lives.
Drugs just happen to be a false hand and a dark place in your life.
Meet the Bad Batch Boys, a group of teenagers using technology to help prevent overdoses.
I've worked in the last 15 years as a game programmer in Baltimore. I've always had a love for art and code, and video games is like a great place to mash those two together. We started coding schools about 5 years ago because we like working with young people and seeing the way in which coding really opens their minds, changes the way they think. Baltimore City, it's majority Black.
You should only get the notification when
our students are what we would consider underrepresented, just a lot of people you don't generally see in tech.
It's just like something that's not really marketed to you, you know, coming from the places I come from. My name is David, and right now I'm teaching coding to public school students. I'm thinking code is insane, complex. You have to be like white for like someone ever to take you seriously. Oh, Mike is the biggest nerd in the world. The biggest nerd in the world. But having a person defy like almost every one of my misconceptions lead me to become like a better coder, which is pretty awesome.
I kind of fell into the harm reduction world accidentally, I would say. I had a friend who overdosed from a batch of heroin that was cut with carfentanil. It affected me a lot. She'd always had struggled with addiction, but she'd managed to make it work. And then, fentanyl and these other drugs hit the street, and no matter how careful you are when those are out there, you're just, these street dealers that are mixing it are not obviously chemists. You know, some of them are taking a spoonful of this and a spoonful of that, shaking it up in a bag, and they get it wrong. And when they get it wrong, it can kill large groups of people. You know, Baltimore City recognizes this problem, maybe more so than any other city, because it's been a problem here for a long time.
Baltimore has been dealing with the effects of heroin abuse since the 1940s. To help curb overdoses, the city developed an email alert that notified healthcare providers of increased overdoses in different areas of the city. But users, the people affected most by potentially dangerous batches of heroin, were left out of the loop.
There was no process in place to alert people that this was out there killing people. You know, it's like, why? What I know how to do is code, and what I know how to do is make these kinds of things, so.
Baltimore is a DIY city. When people see a need, they will band together to create a solution. Mike came up with this idea for a bad batch. It was designed to let users know when there's a bad batch of heroin in their area.
It's a text messaging system, sort of like an Amber Alert or a flood warning. The data starts with an overdose. That data is analyzed on a daily basis, and if they detect a spike in overdoses in a particular neighborhood, that implies that it's likely something different than the usual is going on there. Like maybe somebody has mixed a bad batch of drugs that's killing a particularly large number of people. When we get that information, we can send an alert out to everybody that's registered in that neighborhood and let them know that something's not right. It really makes me excited when the right people are introduced to the topic at the right time. During the weekends is when the Bad Batch team and I would meet and be coding. When I was in high school, it would have taken a lot for me to give up my Saturdays week after week for no pay to work on a coding project. They just kept coming in and chipping away at it.
It's brainstorming. We can just put it down. Click on what spot do you want.
I feel like you should get an alert regardless.
We absolutely have students that would code the pants off of Ivy League graduates, often finding problems with my code and helping me fix them or showing me more efficient ways to do things.
Before Bad Batch, I had no personal involvement with the opioid crisis. I didn't realize the type of things that these people were going through until Mike telling us his story and then personally meeting some of these people. It's crazy.
Their dedication and the scrappiness of them coming together and like toughing it out, they put their all into it.
I didn't think that anything that I'd be doing with my life would impact anybody personally.
What's this page?
my whole experience with Bad Batch, it changes my perception of what I can do for the world. And that's like one of the best things about code. You don't really have to go to college to make a life-changing app to like save people, which is amazing. Everybody has something in them, and all it just takes is, you know, someone to just put in your direction.
I mean, a lot of these people that are addicted are trying to stay alive. They're trying to like fight their addiction, and they're just trying to live their lives, you know? I think it's important that people just remember that all of these people are people that are loved. A message like that would be the world to me, and would hopefully honor her memory.